Lesson 75 SOS. When a light passenger plane flew off course some time ago, it crashed in the mountains and its pilot was killed. Ketika sebuah pesawat penumpang ringan yang terbang beberapa waktu lalu, pesawat itu jatuh di pegunungan dan pilotnya tewas. The only passenger, a young woman and her two baby daughters, were unhurt. Satu-satunya penumpang, seorang wanita muda dan dua anak perempuannya, tidak terluka. It was the middle of winter. Saat itu tengah musim dingin. Snow lay thick on the ground. Salju menghampar tebal di tanah. The woman knew that the nearest village was miles away. Wanita itu tahu bahwa desa terdekat berjarak bermil-mil jauhnya. When it grew dark, she turned a suitcase into a bed and put the children inside it, covering them with all the clothes she could find. Dia mengubah tas jas menjadi tempat tidur dan memasukkan anak-anak di dalamnya, menutupi mereka dengan semua pakaian yang bisa dia dapatkan. During the night, it got terribly cold. Saat malam itu, cuaca menjadi dingin. The woman kept as near as she could to the children and even tried to get into the case herself, but it was too small. Wanita itu menjaga sedekat mungkin dengan anak-anak, bahkan masuk ke dalam kotak itu sendiri, tapi terlalu kecil. Early next morning, she heard planes passing overhead and wondered how she could send a signal. Keesokan paginya, dia mendengar pesawat melintas di atas dan bertanya-tanya bagaimana dia dapat mengirim sebuah signal. Then she had an idea. Lalu dia mendapatkan ide. She stamped out the letters SOS in the snow. Dia mencap huruf SOS di salju. Fortunately, a pilot saw the signal and sent a message by radio to the nearest town. Untungnya, seorang pilot melihat signal itu dan mengirim pesan melalui radio ke kota terdekat. It was no long before a helicopter arrived down the scene to rescue the survivors of the plane crash. Tak lama kemudian, helikopter tiba di tempat kejadian untuk menyelamatkan korban kecelakaan pesawat.